In December 2013, Target Corporation announced that it had experienced a massive data breach that affected up to 110 million customers. The breach exposed customers' personal and financial information, including names, addresses, phone numbers, email addresses, and credit card and debit card numbers.
Here's the inside story on what happened.
The breach began on November 27th, 2013, which was also Black Friday, the busiest shopping day of the year.
The hackers used a type of phishing attack where they sent a malicious email to one of Target's many third-party contractors, Fazio Mechanical, to steal user credentials. An employee of that company opened an attachment in a fraudulent email. Inside that attachment was a Citadel Trojan horse, a malicious software that then spread into Fazio's computers. Through this, the hackers were able to see Fazio's login credentials for Target's network. That got them into the system.
Once inside Target's network, the hackers were able to install malware on the company's point-of-sale systems, POS, which are the devices used to process customer transactions. This malware was designed to capture the credit card and debit card information of Target customers, as well as their names, addresses, and other personal information.
This info was then sold on underground markets.
The breach went undetected for several weeks, during which time the hackers were able to steal data from millions of customers. Target eventually discovered the breach on December 15, 2013, and promptly notified law enforcement and other authorities.
The breach had significant ramifications for Target, its customers, and the broader retail industry. Here are some of the key consequences.
The company had to pay millions of dollars in compensation to affected customers, as well as fines and legal settlements. Target also incurred significant costs associated with improving its cybersecurity infrastructure and implementing new data protection measures.
The breach had a significant impact on Target's reputation. Target's customers lost trust in the company, and many people chose to shop elsewhere. The breach also damaged Target's brand image, and company's stock price fell as a result.
Greg Steinhaffel, CEO of Target, resigned following the data breach. He held himself personally accountable and pledged that Target would emerge a better company.
Target faced numerous lawsuits and regulatory investigations because of the breach. The company had to pay fines and legal settlements to various regulators and law enforcement agencies.
John Mulligan, interim CEO, attended U.S. Senate hearings where he was grilled on how Target handled the breach. When questioned if the company could have had better security measures in place when managing its vendors, he replied yes.
The Target breach also raised public awareness about the importance of data security and the risks of cybercrime. The incident prompted many consumers to take steps to protect their own personal and financial information, such as monitoring their credit reports and using more secure forms of payment.
According to Time magazine, the author of the POS malware program used by the hackers was a 17-year-old teen. The teen denied the allegation.
The breach was a wake-up call for the retail industry, highlighting the need for stronger cybersecurity measures. This prompted many other retailers to review their own cybersecurity protocols and implement new data protection measures. While Target had a $100 million insurance policy that helped them with some of the losses, this next company didn't have anything in place, and the cyber attack completely wiped them out.